So, okay. So first of all, congratulations on the success of Suui, Dhaaga.
Thank you very much.
It's a phenomenal film. I loved them, Laga, Haisha, but I think this is just one step above, in my opinion.
Thank you.
I don't know what you've been hearing between the two films.
It's a mixed thing. Some people think Dham Laga Haisha is...
Well, that also set a pretty high standard also.
It's a different film.
Sir, first thing I wanted to ask you was, I've always, you know, after watching this film as well, your characters and your stories are so earthy, right? They're so rooted in India. They're made in India, right? The opposite, I wanted to ask you, you know, you're somebody who lives in Mumbai, you've been there for so many years, you work in the glamour business. What is it that draws you to these stories, and how do you feel, you know, why these stories, and what drives you to tell them?
It's very simple. It's just what I feel for. You go for something that you feel you can relate to, mm-hmm. and those are the kind of stories that excites one. And that's why you choose that kind of a story.
शादी बन गई है हमारी प्रतियोगिता. या तो मैदान छोड़कर भाग जाओ, या फिर खेलो दम लगा के.
What is your, you know, when you went into making Dham Laga Ke, or when you went into making Suui, Dhaaga, what was that one thing you had in your mind that when the audience walks out of the theater, what is that one thing you aspired?
They should have a smile on their face.
Smile on their face.
Yeah, okay. Always the effort is that they should just walk out from smiling, feeling good. And happy.
Feeling hopeful about life?
Hopeful about life.
That's how I feel. Hopeful
about
life.
And yeah, no matter what, good, bad, whatever days you have.
Yeah.
But keep a smile on your face. And that's the agenda.
You know, I've read and seen many of your interviews, and whenever anybody asks you about your inspirations, you mentioned a lot of directors and writers from the West. I want to ask you, from Hindi cinema, who is that one director or writer or film that's been your catalyst?
Raj Kapoor would be my most favorite director.
Any specific film that
Shri 420.
Mera juta hai Japani ye patloon Englishtani sar pe laal topi rusi phir bhi dil hai Hindustani mera juta hai Japani.
Yeah, that's one film that's made a deep impact on me.
Yeah.
And I watch it over and over again.
And that inspires you?
Keep seeing the songs again and again on YouTube also.
Yeah. Is it true that you wrote Suui, Dhaaga in 20 days?
3 weeks, yeah.
How? Please tell me how.
See, I have a simple belief, and a lot of my writer friends also believe that when the script is clear in your head, then it comes out effortlessly. Hmm. And when you don't know what to do, then you struggle on paper. So that way I would say that whenever an idea is clear to you and what you're trying to say, and when you're very clear about what the film is really about, then pen moves faster on paper.
But for a lot of, you know, young writers, you know, new writers like myself, it's always ki climax theek ho raha hai, nahi ho raha hai, should we fix the interval, should we not? It comes effortlessly.
Climax is something that comes to me first, and then the backstory.
You work backwards.
Yeah, mostly that.
And where does the interval come into all of this?
Interval is an organic thing, you know. I never think of...
You don't plan
in,
for
it. No.
Okay.
But there's a point where you want to stop and take a break in the story. And while writing, it organically happens, you know. There's no plan or no step up line. Okay, this is where we stop the story.
Yeah.
No, there's nothing like that, you know. It just automatically happens.
You know, in the film industry, there's that popular line that the film is made on the writing table and the edit table. Which one of these is the more important table?
Accounts table is.
Accounts.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So that's the most important one out of the three.
One thing is when I write something, I tell myself that I'll keep things simple, not just for the audience and myself, also for the producer.
Sure.
Yeah. So sure. You know, it's you keep budgets under control and make the film as simple as possible.
Yeah.
Without too many gadgets and too many gizmos.
Yeah.
So less number of days.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Well, I think the box office collection of your films proves that.
Yeah. But that's secondary to me, actually.
Right.
Film comes first, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
You know, talking about the film, what's so fascinating to me when I look at Dham Laga Ke and when I look at Suui, Dhaaga is, you were working with very fresh actors in Dham Laga Ke, right? Bhumi was just starting off. First film, right?
Yeah, of course, with you.
Yeah. Ayushman was very new. And now here you're working with stars. Well, they've been around for a decade, you know? Anushka, of course. What is the difference? What is the
not
plan?
Really any. Honestly, not really. Really? Yeah, I also had that preconceived notion when I was about to start work on the film that you know they'll come with any baggage. But you know, when making the film, we were all very scared. Honestly,
okay.
Scared in the sense that I was scared that whether I'll get it right, whether the story I've written, whether it works or no.
Yeah.
एक मिनट, तुम ये तो नहीं करी कि खुद की मशीन यहाँ पे लगाऊँ मैं?
नहीं, ये तो आप कह रहे हैं.
Last question for you. What is, you know, there's so many young filmmakers that probably look up to you, and who, even making that first short film is a struggle. What is the one thing they should do and what is the one thing they should not do, based on your repertoire?
Don't think too much about it, just go ahead and make it, you know.
Just go ahead and make it.
Yeah, good, bad, whatever it is, it's yours.
Okay. And what is the one thing they should not do?
Don't get bogged down by opinions.
Important.
Yeah, listen to yourself.
Yeah.
Most important, yeah.
Excellent, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I really appreciate you taking out the time.
Thank you.